the lake very, very still. No question they'd ever need wetsuits today. Away they go then. Looked a pretty clean start as well.
Look at the turn though from the arms. That's amazing. And the way this course is set up, straight line straight back to the pontoon. And they do that twice so they don't have to worry about podium.
These superb, super slow-mo shots brought to you by our one of our 20-plus
candidates. Lisa Norden right there, very pleased that her swim has improved today. So moving that specialized S-Works bike. And as they get to some of the hills, I think she'll try to make a bit of a break. Olympic gold medalist and three-time world champion. And at some point, the Federation, I think, has to ask the question, do you pull the plug on the season and just let her get healthy? Because we know what a great athlete she is. We know her competitiveness. And probably if I was in that situation, I would just give her a bit of time to recover. There's still 2 full years before the Olympics, and why not allow such a fantastic athlete to just sort of get 100% healthy? Because when you're doing these kinds of two-hour races at such a high intensity and level, you really can't recover if you're not 100%. And we've seen it in the past. You just need that time away from the sport to get healthy, and they actually gave him some property. Ernst Hinterzier was the gold medalist, and he actually...
Some in the lead group, maybe on the run, we'll see. Meanwhile, we're looking at Lisa Norden, who won that terrific race in Hamburg, battle with Moffitt.
Well, this day has certainly changed dramatically for the woman from Team Specialized, mostly because of a great swim. She had a fantastic swim early on, and that allowed her to immediately get into this bike course with the big athletes that she would have anticipated. And you can see right there, they're on a slightly downhill section, so one of the reasons that they're able to get a bit of a drink in and look like they're not working that hard, but they are moving quickly. There's Lisa Norden right at the front. She's always aggressive. There's Andre Hewitt, very aggressive. There is the likes of Emma Moffitt, very aggressive. So they're all in the general positions we would have anticipated. The big names sort of coming off very close to the front. Bike has to be put in first. He's 1-2. Lisa Norden, Holland into that bunch. Daniela Reif. So, I mean, this is people who've been all around the podium all year long, just in that top 4 or 5, recognition of your 2010 season. And Lisa Norden, kudos for hanging tough there. She, you saw a few shots of her on the bike, and she did a good job of staying in that lead group of 5 or 6. She didn't go much beyond the first 5 or 6 for most of the ride. Wasn't as aggressive on the bike.
Doesn't care. She hasn't read the script, Barry. She's taking Norden on, and Norden is struggling to stay with her. It's about 5 or 6 meters the gap, and Findlay looks so composed. Hewitt's out of it. She's going to finish third, but Findlay looks as though she's going to secure back-to-back wins.
Well, it has not been done on the circuit in 2010, and Paula Findlay, the woman who broke through with a victory in London just a few weeks ago, is going to claim her second victory of her career. The only woman with 2 wins on the World Championship circuit in 2010. And Paula Findlay from Canada claims victory one more time here in Kitzbühel, the famous town that so many Canadians have won on the mountain. Now the woman does it in triathlon, second across the line. A terrific day by Lisa Norden. Third will be Hewitt. She will not take over the number one ranked spot.
Away from her. Hewitt had nothing left to give. Great sporting touch at the end, but...
I knew from watching the girls in London that Paula was pretty strong, and in London she took it out with like half a lap to go, so kind of, you know, on my toes, just waiting for someone to do something. And I'm still not quite confident in my running, so I was just kind of biding my time and hoping when, you know, the pace was going to get up that I had some power left in the engine.
You're one of the strongest cyclists in the field. How much did a course like this suit you?
It's good as it makes the other girls maybe suffer a bit more on the run. I just tried to look after myself and, you know, stay out of trouble, keep to the front of the pack and just manage myself through the course. But, you know, it's great to have these courses where the bike actually, you know, plays a role into the final results, and it's not just waiting for the run.
London, which was just 6 days later, but she's back to form here with a silver medal.
Well, most impressive for me was the fact that she had a great swim today. So when her swim is on, she can be a factor. And the fact that she had a great swim means that Darren Smith and her program are really moving in the right direction.
She acknowledged that experience.
Well, Lisa Norden and Andrea Hewitt certainly are experienced at this part of the day.
Experienced sprayers.
Yeah, no question about it. She looks like she's getting a little bit more experience here, although she's still last off.
She's first out of transition.
Yeah.